Hello friends, welcome back. Let's code something now. Here we have just defined a structure type named as student. If we put empty main function and execute this program, it will execute, but there is no memory allocation for any data and there will be no output. Let's see. Program is executed successfully without any output. Memory is allocated when we create variable by using appropriate type. So if we declare any variable like this, program will now reserve memory of appropriate size. We can see it like this. As we know, without proper initialization, there will be garbage or unknown values in memory. In some compilers, values are initialized to zero or null, but it is unpredictable. We can check this by printing values of all three members of the structure S. Let's try something. Here I have just written a code to print all the values. I hope you remember the logic of dot operator in accessing the members of structure. Let's execute this program. See the output. Roll number has got some garbage value, name is null, and marks 0.00. These are the initial values of structure variable S. Now let's see how we can initialize members of structure. Members of structure cannot be initialized here since it is just the declaration of data type. There is no memory allocation when we declare member of the structure in the definition of structure. Memory is allocated when we create the variable of structure. So we can initialize members of structure variable here in the proper sequence. You should be able to see memory diagram for this initialization. Now let's execute the code and see the output. So here you can see in the output, roll number is printed as 44, name Krishna, marks 90.00. We can also assign values individually by using assignment operator. Here we can't use assignment operator to initialize string like this because string is an array and we cannot assign values like this by using assignment operator. If you want to check, let's see what error message we get. It says assignment to expression with array type. What should we do now? I will allow you 1 minute to think. Is anybody able to recall strcpy here? Yes, string function. Let's go for it. We will use string function. For that, we will have to include string dot h header file in our program, and then we will use strcpy to assign name to the member. S dot name is destination and Krishna is the source. S dot marks is single float value which can be assigned by using assignment operator, and that's it. Now let's execute the program. Here you can see the same output: roll number 44, name Krishna, marks 90.00. Now I will create two variables and initialize them. One, s2, let's copy and paste, make some changes here. We'll have a 22. Name Ganesh, percentage 80. Don't forget to make some important changes. It is now s1.rno, s1.name, s1.marks. It is s2.rno, s2.name, s2.marks. Same is here, s1.rno, s1.name, s1.marks. Let's copy and paste. Let's make some changes. s2.rno, s2.name, s2.marks. Let's execute the code. Here you can see we have initialized two structure variables. I hope you understood the execution. Now I am giving you one exercise. Here you have to define one structure employee with 5 members: employee ID, name, age, gender, and salary, and then read information through keyboard for 3 employees and print like a tabular list. Try sincerely. You will find solution in next video. Goodbye.